Blog Talk Radio, the world's largest online radio network.
Hello and welcome. And yes, this is Cynde Meyer, and this is the weekly radio show that is brought to you each and every week by all of the readers of Spirit Seeker Magazine, all of the people who have supported us for over 15 years. Yes, you heard that correctly. 15 years ago, Spirit Seeker was started, and it started off as a newsletter 17 years ago. And then in the September of 1997, 15 years ago, is when our first issue in print came out. We've come a long way since then. We have branched out from St. Louis, reaching across to Kansas City, and then the city, Columbia, Missouri, which is a university town in between Kansas City and St. Louis, was added about 4 years ago. And then a little over a year ago, we added Chicago. Now, the interesting thing is this. Just as with Blog Talk Radio, the minute the radio interviews are done, people know that they are there in the archive. So we get weekly reports, and we have so many listeners who, for whatever reason, sometimes don't listen live, but we know that they're listening later because we get reports as to how many people are listening to the show. Same way with Spirit Seeker. We were one of the first ones to publish online. So the minute the issue is in print, the first of the month, it is online. So if you find articles that you really like, if you find an interview on Blog Talk that you really like, please, please, please send it, send the link to people, send an email saying, hey, there's this great article, or hey, there's this great radio interview. And it's helped us reach our national and international readership. And so I'm just, it's an honor and a privilege to bring this magazine to you each and every month and this radio show each and every week. We have over 200 shows archived for your listening pleasure, and a lot of people, you know, just download them to their iPod and just listen to them with their headsets. So, you know, whatever works. Now, the September issue is online, and this is National Yoga Month, so in just a few moments I'll bring my guest on. But I want to just tell you some of the articles that are in the September issue. One of them is Braco, an Unexplainable Phenomena, and this is the Croatian healer who is just, you know, read the article, I say no more, look into his eyes, and I will be interviewing two people who have worked with him for many years later this month in September. But that article, when you read it, trust me, you're going to say, what in the world is going on here? He stands in front of a room of people and does eye gazing, and people are having miracles in his presence. And this man is not doing it for the money, because he only charges $8 to be in one of his what they call sitting sessions. So that's in this issue. Kripala Yoga, More Than Just a Stretch. Redefining the Peace Movement, one of the best articles I have read on peace in a long time, and I think you will agree after you read that article. And then three more articles, and then, of course, there's others, but these are the ones we highlighted this month. The Highly Sensitive Person, How to Thrive When the World Overwhelms You. These are for the empaths that are walking around not knowing what to do with their skills, with the children who are the crystal children, and you're saying, What's going on? My kid knows things, is very psychic. How do I deal with this? These are highly sensitive people. And the doctor who has written a book on the subject will be my guest next week. No, 2 weeks from now. There's also the Mood Food Connection, Enjoy Your Food. This is by Denise Lynn and her daughter. I believe her name is Summer. And this book is coming out in November. Fascinating book. Fascinating book, all about changing the way you look at food, and we will be running several excerpts from this book, because it is one of the best books that I've read in a long time on, you know, the mood-food connection, how eating and preparing food for your family is not something you just throw together. It's, you know, I've always felt this way. There's love and honoring of the food, and the more love that is infused in the food that you eat, the more the whole family can feel that harmony. The other article is Yoga, More Than Exercise. So here we go. I am bringing on someone that I just recently met, and I felt very drawn to her. She is a yoga teacher. She has a yoga studio, on. And we are going to be hearing about different types of yoga, what drew her, you know, and what I can say is this. I've started yoga in the 1970s, got away from it, went back to it in the 80s, got away from it, and had just started it again in January when I broke my leg. And when I talked to Jennifer, the owner of Ballet Vinyasa Yoga Studio, I thought, oh, this is where I'm going next. I liked her approach. I liked her article. I just liked everything. So, Jennifer, are you there?
I am here, Cynde. Thanks for having me.
Well, it's a big leap of faith,
isn't it?
Oh my gosh, I know. And it's like, and I totally like was cleaning the garage over the weekend, and I think I shared with you that I had fractured this.
Yes.
Oh my gosh, this basketball came out of nowhere, and I pitched forward over it. My son is watching this, right? I look like a whirling dervish. I did two complete spins, possibly three. Like, and all I kept seeing is I kept trying to like stop with the garage floor and thinking that's concrete. Oh my gosh! But I stopped, and I'm wearing my brace. I'm a good girl, so I'm still coming to class.
Yeah. Well, we will be here whenever you're ready. And we are starting this month, actually, next week, two gentle yoga classes. So we'll have something that'll be just perfect for you and anyone coming off of an injury or who's suffering from any kind of limitation or just wants a little bit easier flow.
Yeah. Well, and you know, Jennifer, one of the people testimonials, shall we say, on your website, I'm just going to read it. I came to Ballet Vinyasa 2 months after having my hip replaced. I went to strengthen and improve flexibility in my new hip and fell in love with yoga. The studio makes yoga fun and not intimidating for beginners. I love the variety of teachers and I've learned something important from everyone. It has made a significant impact on my horsestick riding too. I am more centered physically and mentally. Thank you, Ballet Vinyasa. So, you know, people find, and you know, we both, you know, your studio's in Chesterfield,
yes.
Missouri, and that's where I'm living. So tell me how you got started in this. I think your path started, what, in 2009?
Yes, exactly. And like many people, I started practicing yoga primarily as a form of exercise, which I think is the way that many people come to yoga. And I also just fell in love with it and really wanted to find a way to practice every day. And at that time, I was working a lot. I'm a marketing consultant by trade, and most of my clients were out in Chesterfield or even further west. So I started looking for a traditional yoga studio in the area where I could grab a class before or after work or over lunch, and just wasn't able to find anything and was shocked by that because, as anyone who's listening is familiar with the area knows, Chesterfield is such a huge, has such a huge population, and it's a very active lifestyle, I would say, population, and she was just really surprised that there wasn't anything offered. And I don't know, it was a couple months into my search for it that I was sitting there looking at the Google results again, finding nothing, and I had just this thought, like, oh, I get it. I'm supposed to open a yoga studio in Chesterfield, which is a really odd thought because, and I know you introduced me as a yoga teacher, but I'm actually not a yoga teacher.
You know, I remember that as I said it, I was like,
yeah, no, that's
she doesn't teach.
No, I don't. So it's a very odd thought because most people who open yoga studios are, in fact, not only yoga teachers, but people who have been teaching yoga for quite some time. But I guess I thought that, you know, I just saw a need in the market and in that area and thought or hoped that my business skills would compensate for the fact that I don't actually teach and had not been involved in yoga for that long, actually. And 2 years later, we opened just a little over 2 years ago, I think that's more or less come to fruition. We're continuing to grow, and there's still a lot of opportunity for us to meet and reach people in the Chesterfield and West County area. Pete, as the testimonial you read indicated, people who have found us have really enjoyed the studio and the classes and finding yoga in their lives.
Well, and you're offering 18-plus classes a week. So, mm-hmm. you know, for the, okay, since it's National Yoga Month and a lot of our listeners, you mm-hmm. know, may very well be, as you were in 2009 and myself, rediscovering yoga at this point mm-hmm. in my life, going, whoa, things have changed quite a bit. It used to mm-hmm. be there was a yoga class at the community college, and that was about it. But now people are more aware. So tell us the difference. Like, you, I know you offer, like when you were just saying, it's okay, you can come because mm-hmm. we have a gentle yoga class. Mm-hmm. So if you would be so kind, Jennifer, is to just educate the listeners, what are the different kinds of yoga that you are offering, and how is gentle? I know there's Ashtanga. I know there's mm-hmm. okay. And what is vinyasa? What does mm-hmm. it mean? Let's sure. Just talk, and I'll occasionally ask a question.
I was just going to say, stop me if I'm going too quickly over something or if I miss it. Well, I'll start with the word vinyasa and our name, Valley Vinyasa, because, of course, as soon as we opened, that was immediately the most frequently asked question. It's hard to pronounce, and it's not a familiar word to people who haven't studied yoga. Vinyasa simply means to move with your breath. So in almost every form of yoga and in most of the classes that we offer, there's this idea of linking your movement with your breath. So, for example, taking one movement on an inhale and then a subsequent movement on an exhale. And it really helps to focus you on your breathing, which, of course, is central to the practice of yoga. And it's just very good for all of your various systems to move that way. Now, vinyasa is also, or vinyasa flow, is also a specific style of yoga. So a lot of people have heard of that. It's a flowing type of yoga where typically you have one movement with every breath. A lot of our teachers and classes, while they're not called vinyasa perhaps, do tend to be vinyasa style classes. And the nice thing about that is, in addition to all of the mental, emotional, even spiritual benefits of yoga, you also get a very nice workout from a vinyasa flow type class. So that I like to start there because, again, with our name, which is a great name, it does have some confusion sometimes for new people. We, as you mentioned, we have with our fall schedule, which starts next week, we're going to have over 20 classes each week, and they run the gamut from we have a number of basics classes, which are, as the name implies, specifically designed for beginners who are really looking to understand the basics of a yoga class and get down some of the essential postures and movements. But it's also, basics class is also great. Even though I practice yoga almost every day and I'm certainly capable of taking more advanced classes, I love going to basics classes because with the focus on your proper body alignment, you can just really go deep into your practice. So they're appropriate for all levels of students. Some days you just don't feel like really sweating or getting a really tough workout, you're looking for something a little more basic. We have then level 1, 2, and all levels classes as well. As I mentioned, we're adding gentle yoga. And that really was born of one of our teachers' ideas, as many of our classes are. And she just saw a need with some of the students who are coming to her classes in the morning where they really wanted to focus more on the stretching and still adding some strength and some movement, but really really concentrating on the stretching component of yoga. And a lot of these students are either a little bit older or, as we mentioned, they are either suffering from some sort of limiting condition, could be any number of things, or coming off an injury, or just looking for something gentler. So we're adding that this fall, and I'm confident that's going to go well for us. All of our classes are very beginner-friendly, and you will pick that up in some of the testimonials on our website. That's really core to who we are. And so even our all-levels classes, which can and do move at a faster pace and offer some tougher postures, even in those classes, a beginner will be made to feel welcome. The teacher will do everything in his or her power during that class to help that beginner student to feel comfortable in the class. So we really, really, really welcome and love beginners at the studio.
Well, and, you know, let's just talk about that for a moment, because I think I shared with you that I went to Bhakti Fest in...
Oh, my gosh. It was the first ever.
Yes, and they have decided that they are definitely going to bring it back again in 2013, which, you know, made me a very happy girl. Mm-hmm. But I had not been on the floor since the broken leg. You know, I mean, in physical therapy, they had me on a raised platform. And, you know, here I am with Saul David Ray with 250 people, and... I just thought, okay, I'm going to get down on my yoga mat. My friends are here to help me. They'll help me get up. It may not be with grace, but who cares? I'm going to do this. So here I am. You know, it was fascinating to me. You know, they drew from so many states in the Midwest. And I was next to this guy who had never, ever done yoga before in his life until 3 months before this. But he was from Poland, living in Chicago, and someone told him he's an athlete, you know, and but he's like not a young guy. He's like he's young to me. I'm close to 60, but you know, he was in his early 30s, and someone said, you know what, you'll be a better athlete if you take yoga. So this guy started doing yoga. He was able to follow every movement, and he told me, he said, it has changed my life.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and one of the girls that was with me had never done yoga before in her life, and of all things, she was pictured on the Bhakti Fest website. I'm like, that is not an accident. You need to do yoga more. You know? But I had never been in a room with that many people doing yoga ever, and you know, so because I was in that wheelchair in the hospital bed for like 10 or 12 weeks, and then on a walker and then on a cane, I mean, you can imagine my whole, everything was like off kilter. The assistant to the teacher came and just did a couple little tiny suggestions. And all I can tell you is my whole rib cage opened in a way that it, you know, that it had not opened in a long, long time. And so it's just these tiny little things. And so with gentle yoga, I guess what I want to say is, and correct me, you know, if I need to be corrected here, this was an advanced class, but what it also was basic. And, you know, and what they say is, you know, and this is what I've heard over and over, is do what you feel comfortable with.
Yeah.
Know where your edge is. And you know, you're still in the energy of it, whether you're doing everything or not.
Yeah. And I really try hard to explain that to new students who call on the phone. And so many people are intimidated by, you know, maybe the only classes on our schedule that really work for their schedule are all levels classes, but they're afraid to do that. But to your point, what I try to explain is, it really doesn't matter what class you come to. Yes, in an all-levels class, there may be poses that are offered that you're just not able to do right now, but there's always an alternative. There's always a modification, and there's always the popular child's pose, which I hope you familiarize yourself with.
Yes.
You know, so and the nice thing also is it doesn't matter what you're doing. You're not going to disrupt anyone else's experience on the mat. You're not going to bother the teacher or the class energy by, you know, not doing every posture or doing it to its fullest extent. It just doesn't matter.
Yeah. So let's talk about this. I'm on your website right now, which I want to, listeners, it's valleyvinyasa.com, which is valley, V-A-L-L-E-Y, V-I-N-Y-A-S-A.com. Now, this is what you're going to find when you get there. Exactly what Jennifer just described. There's a yoga basics class. There's a level 1 to 2 yoga. There's all levels yoga where, you know, all different levels come and you do what you can. But there's something to be said about being inspired by seeing what is possible.
Well, I agree.
So really, it has no bearing. I mean, I'm like a testimonial to this. Here I am. I can't. You know, I really am not able to go on this knee yet, you know, with kneeling down on my knee. But I just, those few little tweaks, I was like, this is so much better. But then you also have opened Hatha Yoga, restorative yoga, and are you still offering the heated vinyasa?
We are offering that about once a month.
Okay.
We have a class coming up September 17th in the morning. So it's not a weekly class on our schedule, but we try to sprinkle it in whenever we can get the teacher there.
Okay. And then you also offer vinyin. So if you would be so kind, would you please tell us what Hatha Yoga is? Like, because a lot of people have heard of Hatha Yoga.
Right.
So let's talk about that.
I think the simplest way to describe it is that Hatha Yoga is kind of the general umbrella term for most of the types of yoga that are practiced here and in the physical sense, the physical forms of yoga. So in our Hatha Yoga classes, there's, I would say, less vinyasa flow, but you're still going, you know, you're still going to experience most of the traditional yoga postures, from triangle pose to, you know, forward bends and warrior poses and all that sort of thing. They just might be linked together a little bit differently. In the open Hatha class also, because Hatha is such a broad term, occasionally the teacher will introduce something that's just a little bit different. So one of our instructors of that particular class, once a month, his Hatha class is a yin class, which is a very different type of energy. Sometimes in that class, he'll offer my very favorite thing in the world, which is called yoga nidra, which is
I've heard of this.
Oh, my gosh, it's heaven. Oh,
yeah, I forget who told me, and they said, you need to learn about this. It's
yes.
called, okay, so describe yoga nidra to us.
Okay. That could be so all in and of itself. Yoga nidra is also called yogic sleep. And I've heard it described, and this is probably the easiest way to translate it, and I would attest to this. It's almost like being hypnotized. I've never actually been hypnotized, but I believe this, where you're very conscious and aware, or, you know, you're not asleep,
right?
But you're under.
It's
so
deep. It's like when you meditate or when you do
exactly.
breath work, and all of a sudden you're there, but you're not. You're like,
yeah.
It's when the guides step in. It's when the deep work gets done.
Yeah. So the way that class works, and again, this is just something that Joe particularly offers when I beg him to in open the Hatha class, is you'll start out with some movement because the body needs to release some of that energy and all of that, and then so that's usually about 45 minutes of the class, and then the last 30-35 minutes he'll take you into this yoga nidra, and he just has a very specific meditative talk that he kind of takes you through that and is very instructive and helps you get to that place. And it's just, well, they say when you wake up from being hit or you come out of being hypnotized, you feel like you've gotten an 8-hour sleep, right?
Wow.
And yoga nidra is kind of the same way. You've been kind of out of it or under for, you know, maybe 15-20 minutes or so. And when you wake up or come out, boy, you feel like you've had a full night's sleep. So it's wonderful. It's a great experience. So the open Hatha just gives the teachers the freedom, or not, of course all the teachers have freedom, but they'll offer sometimes things that are a little bit different than more what you traditionally experience in a vinyasa flow type class. Does that help?
It absolutely does. And you also have a blog.
Yes, we do. Chesterfield Yoga Blog.
Yeah.
Yes.
And you have an article that you just published recently in May, 5 Reasons Why Yoga Workshops Rock.
Mm-hmm.
I think this is a great article.
Thank you.
Well, it is. And, you know, you also have a workshop coming up.
Yes,
let me find
we
that.
Do.
And that's Core Vinyasa Workshop.
Yes.
You know, listeners, that's for any of you in the St. Louis or visiting St. Louis, it's on Sunday, September 23rd from 11 to 1:30, and it's pretty much the first sentence is pretty much what Jennifer's been talking about. It says this workshop will guide you through specific postures, pranayama, which is breathing, and vinyasa, the flow sequences to strengthen and activate your core muscles. Now, so this is a beginner, though, for anyone who just wants to start learning, but it also, like, what this will do is ease back pain, improve posture, and aid in digestion because you're working with the muscular system and the breathing.
Yes. And clearly, all of your strength comes from your core. And so when it comes to, you know, a lot of people come to yoga because they've been advised by a doctor or a chiropractor or a physical therapist that, you know, because of back problems. Maybe it's not obvious, but the way to prevent back injury or back pain problems is through a stronger core. Yoga definitely will help you with that in a safe way. And this workshop, it's just a more concentrated focus on those on strengthening your core, which is key not only to yoga but to pretty much everything we do, including just walking around.
I'm going to interrupt for a second because Wayne Dyer, most of you have heard Wayne Dyer's name. Wayne Dyer had back problems for years and years and years, did everything and everything. And then, you know, he lives on Maui, and someone said, you need to do yoga. He's like, oh, blah, blah, blah. And they're like, no, 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 you don't get it. It would take your back pain away. Do you know, I mean, Wayne Dyer is a funny guy. I mean, he's got his start in St. Louis on KMOX. He filled in for, you know, someone that, you know, was, like, out on vacation for a week, and he gives a lot of credit to St. Louis. And I don't know. The man is just very instrumental. I don't know. He's just a great guy. So
he is. I agree.
Okay, so he started doing this yoga. Well, now, I mean, he reads a book a day. This guy is one. He swims his mile on Maui. I was there when he did it. You know, and he said, you can, you know, told the people in the workshop, 500 and something people. He says, you can swim with me, but you cannot talk to me or try and get. No, this is my process. I do it every day, and he does yoga in a heated studio every single morning. And then one at some point, the yoga teacher actually had some kind of an illness. He paid for her studio for I think it was like 2 or 3 months, so that other teachers could continue. You know, while she was recovering, he's like, we can't have you going out of business. No, 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 no.
That's how good he is
because his back pain is gone. So he does yoga every single morning, 6 o'clock in the morning when he's on Maui, you know, every single day. So, you know, and the core thing, you know, talking about that core, you know, I did do yoga. I did private lessons because I was just like, you've got to be kidding. I was just so out of shape, and I went through breast cancer 6 years ago. And at the time, I did restorative yoga, and I noticed that you're offering that. And for me, restorative, I mean, sometimes I would fall asleep. But it was the most deep relaxation, similar to what you were describing with the yoga nidra. But can you tell our listeners, you know, like he even suggested, he said, you know, this was, you know, like, as I said, over 6 years ago, and he suggested that I come to the multiple sclerosis. Like, he says, just come to the MS group. And I'm like, I am not going to come to the MS group. I am like a young person. He says, you don't get it. No one cares. You know, and he said it's restorative, you know, but it was like at, I don't know, sometime when it wasn't convenient. But I noticed that you're offering restorative. So
I know what it did for me,
but can you talk just a little bit about that? What anyone can come to that. You don't have to be sick to come to restorative.
No, restorative is wonderful for virtually anyone. And in fact, I think I also have a blog post. It's probably going back a few months, but do you need restorative? And the answer is, well, I don't know. Do you have any stress in your life? If you do, you probably could benefit from it. Restorative leads yoga, which we offer in an hour and a half class, typically on Friday evenings, leads you through a series of postures. And in that time, you're only going to do maybe, I don't know, 6 or 7 postures, and some of them are on 2 sides, so, you know, you might multiply that by 2. But you're going to hold them for a long time, 5, maybe even 10 minutes each. And you're going to use, well, this is what's wonderful about it, is you're going to use lots of props, bolsters, blankets, other things to hold you in place So that there's really no effort whatsoever in a restorative class.
I can attest to this. I can attest to this. I mean, I mean, when we would be finished with, you know, the restorative, I would just look at all the blankets, the props, everything. But what it did, you know, because I had a mastectomy, and you know that I was splinting, you know, that side of my chest because, you know, I'd been through 3 6-hour surgeries by the time I you know, with everything, and so what Jennifer's describing is so that you don't feel awkward. Your body is supported. It's just otherworldly almost, you know, but your body learns to trust again is how I look at it, you know, with opening and I don't know, because, you know, after you've had any, and this isn't, you don't have to have breast cancer or an injury to do this, but if you just have not had your body open, restorative is really, as Jennifer said, if you have had a lot of stress, you don't realize that, like, a lot of times your shoulders are up, or if you've been sitting in front of a computer, as I do with, you know, when I'm at deadline time, it's like, you know, hours sitting, you know, and so, yes, restorative.
Yeah, any tightness, achiness, even mental distraction, those are the sorts of things that restorative can really help for both your body and your mind. And most of us have some of that.
Okay.
These days.
Oh, my gosh. It's like we're almost out of time. So here's the thing. I just want to mention, you know, in the September issue of Spirit Seeker, all you have to do is go to spiritseeker.com. You click on the cover, and the cover this year in honor of our 15th anniversary is Kuan Yin's crown. It has the beautiful third eye that, you know, we are wanting to open with all of these meditation, yoga, all these different practices. It's not, you know, what I really like about the two, you know, three articles, you know, one we did the feature on Jennifer's studio, but the other one is yoga, more than exercise, yoga, more than just a stretch. It works with your mind, your body, and your spirit. And you can read, you know, all of these different articles in this issue of Spirit Seeker. But, you know, Jennifer, you know, I just think you were fabulous. And
I'm so glad we got connected, and I have one of my students to thank for that. And I just sent her a note today to thank her again for introducing us. I'm thrilled to be a part of your magazine and your radio show now.
Oh, my gosh.
So,
well,
and
you'll be seeing me. You'll be seeing me. And the knee is not stopping me. If I have to have bolsters and someone helping me up, I will be there.
Yep.
So I just thank you so much. And once again, the website, listeners, is valleyvinyasa.com. This is in West St. Louis County. But, you know, it's worth the drive. And there are different workshops. And, you know, I mean, it just, thank you so much for being my guest tonight.
Oh, thank you, Cynde.
Okay.
All right. Have a good evening.
Okay.
Right.
Thank you. Now, listeners, bye. Listeners, this is a two-part show. I'm going to bring my second guest on in just a moment, but before we do that, I just want to mention that there are several ways to support the show. If you send an email to info@spiritseeker.com, we will then send you a notice about the radio shows, about all the different events, when the magazine is online, and as many of you have learned, our print magazine in the Midwest is much larger online, and that will continue to grow larger online because guess what? The printing costs do nothing but continue to escalate, and so we do have additional articles that are online only, but the two guests that I have tonight are in our print magazine in the September issue. Now, the other thing is if you go to blogtalkradio.com/Cynde Meyer, CyndeMeyer, and if you favorite the show, what it does is it moves us closer to the front of the there are thousands of radio shows offered on Blog Talk each and every week. And if you favorite the show, what it does is it lets lets Blog Talk know that you're listening, that you like the show, that, you know, hey, guess what? Cynde Meyer's show is getting listeners. And what it does is it helps us reach more people. It's not an ego thing at all. It just, the whole deal with Spirit Seeker for 15 years has been helping people find resources for the mind, body, and spirit. I also want to mention that we have our Purple Pages Wellness Directory that will be coming out with our December issue. It will be printed in the December issue, but it will be online at purplepagesusa.com. So there will be advertising rates for if you want to be in the Midwest edition of the the wellness directory and where people hold on to this. But if you want to just be online only, so maybe you're like, you know what, I just want to pay less, I want to be on the website for the year, then that's an option as well. And if you're interested in any of this, you just send me an email to info@spiritseeker.com. Okay, so now, Isabel, are you there? Is my second guest here?
I'm here.
Oh, good, good, good. Okay. So,
how are you doing, Cynde?
I am great. How are you, Isabel?
I'm doing great. Thank you for having me on the show tonight.
Oh, my gosh. It's my pleasure. And, you know, so let me explain how this has come to be that I have met Isabel. I, Spirit Seeker, hosted its 27th Holistic Living Expo on July 15th, and there is this little lady with high energy, and I do mean high energy. She tracked me down in the hallway and she said, "Hello, hello, hello, I'm Sister Cecilia, and I just want to thank you so much, blah, 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 blah." And, you know, on and on she went. Okay, well then, shortly after the expo, I was out of town. Sister Cecilia called. She called again. She sent me an email. I said, "Sister Cecilia, I am so sorry. I am out of town. Very hard to talk." Well, she says, "But you need to connect with Izzy, la, 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 la." So then Isabel and, well, before you and I even talked, Sister Cecilia and I had this conversation. She tells me this story that then leads me to you, and I finally got, oh, my gosh, no wonder she is calling me. I need to, like, really, like, get my antenna up and connect with this lady. So here we go. I'm sorry, what?
She's my PR person.
Oh, my gosh. You couldn't have anyone more, like, on your team. So do you prefer Izzy or Isabel? Which do you
Isabella.
Prefer? Okay, Isabella. All right.
Yes.
So, Isabella, tell us, okay, what we're going to talk about is the Harmony Festival 2012, but what I want to talk about before we even talk about it is how this has come to be.
How the festival or S's piece?
All of it.
All of it, okay.
Okay, so you just start and you share, and I'm going to listen, and all of our listeners are going to listen. So,
okay.
So let's hear your vision. Okay.
Okay. S's piece was a vision that Spirit gave to me about 2 years ago. He showed me a community, a safe place for light workers and peacekeepers and halos of all kind, and kept showing me the vision of this land and this community. And I said, okay, here I am from the East Coast looking for something in Missouri that I don't know what I'm looking for. So long story short, it kind of fell into my lap. And again, I said, well, I'm glad that, you know, we found the property, which was quite a lot of ego work for me to let go of what I had and come into this mission that I was doing. And I said,
Wait one moment. Let's go back. You were living East Coast.
That's right. I was living on the East Coast in Massachusetts.
And you heard in meditation to move to Missouri.
I had already come to Missouri when I heard in meditation that this was the place that the safe place for light workers and peacekeepers and healers would be.
Okay.
So I kind of was a transplant from the East Coast to St. Louis a few years back.
Okay, and it's not just you. You have a family and a husband.
I have a family, yes I do. I have 6 children.
This is not just,
and they want me to
all
mention their names. I'll give you the 3 youngest, Sadie, Grace, and Joseph. Hello. they've been walking this journey with me.
Oh, my gosh. So you just listen to Spirit. You uproot everything, move to Missouri, but you don't know what you're looking for exactly, but you know that there's this place.
Absolutely. That's exactly how it happened. Yep. And so I continue to just follow. I keep doing my ego work back and forth because I'm like, oh, I don't want to do this. Yes, I do. No, I don't. Yes, I do. So I found the property because I kept seeing the front gate of the property or the entrance to it. So that was about the only, I guess, clue that that Spirit gave to me. And I was like, okay, when I see it, I'll know it. So I came upon it accidentally. Well, not accidentally. I guess it was waiting for me, waiting for all the light workers. And again, I said, okay, now what do I do? Because where do I come up with the funding for this community and all these buildings and all these things and the self-sustainable place that these light workers and peacekeepers and healers are going to be at? And about 2 days after that, I was talking to a friend. And I was like, you know, I got a vision of this person I'm supposed to be talking to, but I don't know who she is. And I started describing where I was talking, or I heard her talking to somebody in this room, and I could hear these yappy dogs. And I was going on and on with this friend of mine, and she went, I know who that is. And I'm like, you know who I'm talking about? And she said, yeah, but they don't live near here. They live, like, on, you know, down in the Gulf Coast. And I'm like, you know who I'm talking about? And she said, yeah. And so I got on the telephone with this person, and about 28 seconds into the conversation, she said, yes. She said, you get the property, you follow what you're being called to do, I'll purchase the property, but I'll be a friend of Jesus, and the property will be for light workers. Amen. 3 months later, we moved in.
Wasn't this friend Sister Cecilia?
No, it wasn't, no.
Oh, I thought, so I misunderstood this part. So Sister Cecilia has now heard this story, and she's like your big spokesperson, I'm telling you. She is like your favorite fan here. You know, so this is hysterical. So this is 150 acres in the Ozark Mountains.
That's correct. We're in the Ozark Mountains.
And didn't the people say they were waiting? They knew that they wanted to do something in Jesus' name, but they were waiting for your call. I mean, did I imagine that part of it? Or
no, you didn't imagine it. They actually, I guess, had come into some money and heard in meditation or in prayer that they were supposed to do something with this money, and they weren't sure what to do with it, but they knew it had something to do with light workers and that they would know the person. So as soon as she heard me talking, she was like, you're the person. This is what I'm supposed to be doing. Yes, this is what I'm supposed to be doing. And she pretty much, she followed what she was being guided to do, and so did I. And here we are 19 months later.
Oh, my goodness.
With Essers Peace in full bloom.
Okay, so tell us what Essers Peace means.
Miss Esser is a guide of mine on the other side. And she has been with me since I was a child. And while I was going through this process of moving out to Essers Peace, and my ego kept pulling me back to my beautiful home and so forth in St. Louis, not that I don't have a beautiful home here, but you know how your ego works.
Oh, I know. And you have six kids, and you have a husband. I mean, I'm sorry, but that's a big deal. I grew up with six kids. Yeah, I mean, you know, my family,
right.
I can't even imagine. I can't even imagine having a husband as wonderful as yours is to say, okay, Isabella.
Uh-huh.
You know, I mean, but you know, that's how spirit is. But it sounds like, you know, your whole family, like, is tuned in.
Yeah, they're great little light workers themselves, and very fortunate. It just kind of came. And we worked through it all and got the place. It was a total disaster when we moved in. We refurbished all the buildings, the whole property. It's just a gorgeous, gorgeous piece of loving, light-filled property now. And it's just a gift, and it's for all people. I tell people all the time, it's not mine, it's not yours, it's ours. It's just for everybody to just come and be and vibrate love and light. And it's just been a beautiful experience, and I couldn't imagine stepping back in time and living like I was before. I wouldn't change it for the world.
So, okay, so your big celebration, your party, your kickoff, whatever you want to call it, but this is an opening and a portal that you're offering to all of us.
Yes.
Is the Harmony Festival 2012. So let's you know, take the rest of the time and talk about that and what your vision is for this land, et cetera. So tell us about the Harmony Festival that's happening September 28th, 29th, and 30th.
The Harmony Festival also came to me. Someone was talking to me about people just about a month ago or so, maybe a little longer, talking to me about people getting together in Washington, D.C. I can't remember the context of the conversation other than Washington, D.C., and people getting together and meditating.
Oh, I know the story, but go ahead and I'll tag in.
Yeah, once you were telling me that story, I went, that's it. That's right. That's what we need to be doing. So, of course, I went right into, you know, reaching out to Spirit. What should I be doing? What should I be doing? And I could just, you know, I could just envision thousands of people mm-hmm. coming together and holding the same vision and the same vibration of love and peace and harmony and just making such a shift, just all being together doing that, making such a shift because there's so much mistrust and fear. You know, when I leave Essers, I always talk, leave my world of Essers Peace and go out there, you know, and I feel like some people have so much fear and mistrust. And,
I said,
if we can get all these people together and hold the same vision and this vibration of just pure love and peace and harmony, wow, we're going to rock Missouri.
Right. I'll tell you what happened in Washington, D.C. I know the story very well. Okay, it was the Transcendental Meditation. The Transcendental Meditators went to the White House lawn, mm-hmm. and they meditated. And they did it, I forget how many hours. It wasn't overnight or anything. I think it was like 8 or 10 hours, and they measured crime. They went 50 to 75 to 100 miles out. And what they noticed when the people came together with intention of peace and harmony, and that's all they focused on is peace and harmony while they were meditating, it the crime rate, it may even be more than 100 miles out. Significantly, it's like they could see where it was, and they could see exactly as they meditated and it rippled out. They could see the crime just dropping significantly. And what it is where, you know, two or more gathered in my name, when then you multiply that, you know, to that level of any time people come together in conscious intention, especially the transcendental meditators that, you know, I mean, that's how I was classically trained in meditation. You know, I was with my first Swami when I was, like, you know, in my early 20s, but then early 30s, I learned my mantra, and, you know, and I still, you know, as many different forms of meditation I'm trained in, I still come back to my TM mantra when my mind is the busiest, because then I can just, like, bring it back. And that's what you're describing. So
yes, that's exactly the story she was telling me.
Yes, it's and I mean, it's documented. They, you know, they did this scientific study on it. So I mean, you can actually do a Google search for it and find this whole deal. So for you, I mean, you have people coming from how many states now? Do you know? I mean, have you kept track?
I could probably list off, I don't know how many, but I could probably list off. At this point, we're up over 1,400 people that are RSVP'd.
Yes.
And that does include the people that didn't RSVP, that it's probably just going to show up.
Right.
We have them coming from Wisconsin, Michigan, Arkansas, Oregon, California, Florida, Alabama, Pennsylvania, Texas. They're just coming out of everywhere, and they all feel like they're being called to do this. And almost everybody that I speak with, and I spoke with thousands of people via email and telephone, just they all say, wow, it's so amazing that you're doing this. This is what we're being called to do. We've been waiting for something like this to happen.
Right.
So I'm just imagining this huge shift in the whole planet.
Right.
It's just, I get chills. I get so excited when I talk about it. I can't wait for it to all happen.
Well, and if any of you are listening that want to be a vendor, I mean, Isabella has made the booth prices so incredibly reasonable.
Yes.
$65 for the whole weekend. You know, the event is free. There's a small charge for the cabins, and, you know, but you can camp. There's no drugs, no alcohol, no any of that nonsense, and they're asking
no pets,
because with that volume of people, pets would make it a little complicated and noisy. And, you know, there's meditation, there's spirit drawings, there's healings, there's massage therapy, yoga, meditation, energy healing, there's Native American ceremonies, there is music, there's nutritional food, there's Qigong, there's a think tank. Did I cover it all, Izzy? I mean, Isabella,
yes,
I'm sorry. There's just like
dancing.
So many things, you know.
We have drumming going on. The way I guess we're going to we're just going to kind of go with the flow of the spirit. But our intention is to, you know, come in Friday evening, everybody gets settled. We have 125 acres of cleared camping ground. But people who don't want to stay in the cabins, we do have 15 cabins, and we can accommodate up to 45 people. We probably have about 10 beds left now. Those are $25 per night per bed. And like I said, we have the cleared camping grounds. So they come in Friday. We have a stage being built. We have three or four bands playing. One's Brother Leadfoot, I believe. Sorry, I don't have a list in front of me. I apologize. We have the Boys from Out of Town playing.
You got the Driftaways. You got the Driftaways, a reggae band.
That's right. We got the Driftaways. I'm glad you got the list in front of you. I apologize. We have people playing chimes. So we're going to kind of come in Friday and just all get settled. I've made it very inviting for vendors. We're still looking for more vendors. We have more spaces for them. We're also going to have a community kitchen. We're asking everybody to just bring whatever they want to bring in their coolers and just share it with everybody around them. We have a big community kitchen being set up where we can heat up food, keep it cool, share it with each other. We also have a trading post going on where people can bring clothes, dishes, rugs, those kind of things, and trade with each other.
Oh, my goodness.
Just trading things off. A lot of children coming. We have a woman that's in charge of all the children's events. There's some beautiful children's events going, working with Mother Earth, those kind of things going on during the festival. And on Saturday morning from dawn till noontime, we're asking everybody to be silent in honor of Mother Earth, Mother God, Father God, Spirit, just to be silent. And then at noontime, we will ring the chimes in the first hayfield. And they are beautiful chimes being made by Steve and Kathleen Quartel. And they're going to ring the chimes and kind of all gather together in the field and start to and just go from there, and wherever Spirit leads us, that's pretty much how it's going to go. So.
You know what? I have been in silent retreats before, you know, and, you know, one of the most most advanced trainings I've ever taken was where, I don't know, I've done so many workshops, and I know you have too, but this one was just remarkable in that we were assigned a roommate we had never met before, and we were allowed, we had like 30 minutes to talk the night before we went into total silence the next morning. And I remember, you know, we had an assignment. We were to take a walk with nature for 30 minutes before we came to the hall where the breakfast was. And no talking. And then we had breakfast in total silence. And I have to tell you something. It was fabulous. You know, when I've been at Unity Village, when, you know, there's a group that comes and does their retreat there, and they'll talk to you on Friday night because someone came up to me and said, I need to talk to you now because we want to advertise in Spirit Seeker, but I have to do it tonight because tomorrow we go into silence, and we're in silence for the rest of the weekend. And, you know, they would be in the middle of a crowded, you know, hall with all of us, like, you know, actually it was Jonathan and Andy Goldman and Sound Healing, but they were all there, a huge group, all in silence amidst all of us. But there's something to be said for nurturing the soul with that quiet, and especially with that many people being in silence. Now, of course, you'll hear children, but even the children, you'll hear they're giggling because, you know, but it will be silence for the adults. That is powerful.
I believe just being silent gets you a little more centered.
Oh, yes.
And just more connected to Mother Earth. And what an amazing opportunity to just vibrate your loving energy in that silence.
Do you have a website, or is it strictly phone calling, or how do people find out more about this?
We don't have a particular website, but we do have a Facebook page, which is called Essers Peace, and we also have a Facebook page called Harmony Festival 2012 Free. If you're not able to get on any of those kind of things, some people said, "Well, I couldn't find it." You're welcome to Facebook me. My name is Isabella Abood, A-B-O-O-D. Just let me know what you're looking for. I'll send you a link. You can also call me at 573-689-1468.
Okay, so you're hearing music, art, drumming, dancing, sharing, yoga, spirituality, meditation, la la la. Okay, so this is the Harmony Festival 2012 with over 1,400 people pre-registered, which means you're going to have way more than that because you know how it is. Mm-hmm. People wait to the last minute, and, you know, the Midwest is called the Show Me State. And, I know how this works. I've done this work for a long time, and it's like people wait to the last minute, and then they're like, let's head to Esther's place. And I do want to mention that is E-S-S-E-R
and then the word peace,
peace, like P-E-A-C-E. This is in Bunker, Missouri, which is in the middle of the Ozarks, which is really quite beautiful, and leaves are already starting to drop in the Midwest because of this crazy summer we had. So it's a beautiful time to be with Mother Nature, Father Sky, and Mother Earth, Father Sky, whatever, and just, you know, immerse yourself in this. But, you know, Izzy, we have a little bit longer. What I'd like to do for the last part of this interview is, what is your vision for once you've kicked off this amazing, you know, blessing for everyone that will radiate out? The other thing is Missouri is known as the heart chakra. When you take a physical body and put it on the United States, we are the heart chakra of the country. And, you know, everything kind of radiates out. And, you know, not even kind of, what am I saying? It's basically we are the heart. We are the center. And, you know, so what is your vision once you've kicked off this fabulous, amazing festival? What is your vision for the future with Essers Peace?
My vision is to always have the gates and doors open for all light workers, peacekeepers, and healers to come and just have a safe place to be, whether it be retreating, whether it be just coming out and doing vision quests, whether it's coming out spending a day because they want to be in Mother Nature, whether they want to come out and live here for a month, 6 months, a year, whatever they're being called to do, just have a safe space where you're accepted for who you are, what you believe in, what you're being called to do, and not being judged. I hope that when everybody leaves the Harmony Festival, that they're full of just vibrating love and energy and peace, and they go out there and just keep on passing it on. I hope to do this annually. I'd like to see the community grow. I'd like to see Essers Peace grow. I'd like to see more people come out and and take, you know, use the land, not use the land, I hate to use the word use, flourish.
Experience the gift of Mother Nature.
Yeah, and the vibration here is incredible. It's beautiful.
Well, and talk about the mountain that you saw in your visions, and then here's this peak.
Yes, we had definitely, it took me a while to get acclimated to this elevation. A lot of the cabins are at the bottom of the mountain, but just coming up to Esther's piece, you do a little mountain climbing, which is very unusual for Missouri, in my experience anyway. So you do your climb up, and you get up on top of this mountain, and it's almost like you're living in a treehouse. And you're looking out, you can just see so much beauty and just so much so much of spirit's work. You look out, and you're like, wow, you know. I guess the word I call it is wow.
Well, and see, people think Missouri's flat, but, you know, we you know, Illinois, we have Cahokia Mounds. You go to Ohio, there's Monk's Mound. And then here we are in Missouri in the Ozarks. People do not realize that these are like little miniature mountains. They truly are. I mean,
they truly are. You when you come in from St. Louis and you come up in this mountain, you're like, okay, I'm on a mountain. We're not Yeah,
wow.
Jeff, it's definitely a beautiful experience in the nature around here and the flowers and the trees and just things that someone was telling me the other day. You have more things growing out there than almost anywhere in the country, just in this whole mountain Ozark area. And I'm like, really? And I started looking into it, and the plants and the flowers. And
The wildflowers and everything else.
Yeah.
So listeners, this is a place how far from St. Louis? It's not that far.
No, it's a little over 2 hours.
Yeah, 2 hours from, you know, from St. Louis, and, you know, so
and
it's
also
not
2 hours from Springfield, exact same distance.
Oh my gosh, I didn't realize it was equidistant. So
Yeah. This
is a place that you can rent for workshops, you can rent for retreats, you can come for your own soul level work. You know, there are cabins that, you know, are available, and are there kitchens? Like, if someone were to say, I just want to come for a weekend, how would they eat?
Well, we have community meals here, so people that are here, we generally all get together in the main house, and we all eat together. All the cabins are heated and air-conditioned.
Oh, my gosh, how lovely.
So they're not that primitive. They're actually like walking into a condo. they've all been over. They're very nice, comfy beds and air conditioning and heat and all the nice things in life.
And you know what? There's nothing wrong with that. So,
right.
I mean, but yet there's camping available. You know, most of you, you know, listeners, you know, I went to Bhakti Fest, and my original intention was to camp. But, you know, I fractured my knee and my ankle in early, late January, and all I could think of when it was like 100 degrees outside.
Where's the air conditioner?
I was like, I just looked at those little campgrounds, and I went, no. So I stayed in the hotel. But if I had had a cabin, trust me, I would have been in a cabin, because we had to drive to and from. And this is like all... Once you arrive at Harmony Festival 2012, you are there. And,
you are,
you know,
here, and we have accommodations for everybody, whether it be the fancy cabins, the more rural cabins with air conditioning, with heat, camping, closer to the events, far away from the events. We have it all available.
Now, Isabella, do you still need volunteers?
We are always looking for more volunteers, not knowing the number of people that are coming in. We're going to be calling the volunteers peacekeepers, and everybody who does volunteer will receive a free shirt that says peacekeeper, so that during the festival, if anybody has questions, needs help of any kind, someone can come to you, and you'll know what to do. So
you
can be able to contact, and we'll all have radios on us and so forth, so that everybody's safe and all is well. So, yes,
and
we are definitely in need of volunteers. We're definitely in need of anybody who's creative in any aspect. We're always looking for people to do paintings, banners, signs. We still got signs we need to get done. We are still trying to build a stage at this point. Anybody who does construction, please call me. Write me.
Yes.
Send me a letter.
You're hearing. Isabella will work with you. You might come and help with this, and then the next thing she says, just come and stay with us for a weekend for thanking, for all of this. And so if you are listening to this and you feel called, no matter where you are in the U.S., you know, just get to the Midwest. And, you know, with an event like this, days ahead, it doesn't matter. You know, Isabella's going to need help. And then also, Isabella, we have a Spirit Seeker Facebook page, as well as, Cynde Meyer Facebook page. If you will share that, you know, friend request me if you would, because I don't think I'm a friend with this. I don't think I've actually seen this on Facebook. So if you send Cynde Meyer or Spirit Seeker a Facebook friend request, then I will, of course, accept, and then I will post this, and I'll like your event, which, you know.
Oh, fantastic. I will post a link to your page.
Yeah, Facebook is the way. It's like.
Facebook is the life. I don't know. Teenagers hooked me onto it, and that's it, I guess.
Oh, I know. My kids laughed. You know, I have kids that I've raised, you know, that are in their 30s, stepchildren, and, you know, all the way down to my youngest is 14. And when I first got my Facebook page, my kids were like, what? You're on Facebook? But I have to tell you, it's like I keep up with what's going on. Well, my youngest one, he blocked me.
Oh, that happened with one of my youngest ones did that, too. They're 14, too.
I know. And I said, you know what? I just don't make a big issue of it because I know he's friends with his brother and sister, and they let me know if anything's going on that shouldn't
You're
be
right.
going on.
You just told a secret. They're listening.
Oh, I know. No. You know, no. The 14-year-old's at basketball practice. He'll be home in a few minutes. But you know, the whole thing is this. Facebook is the way to go,
yeah.
and we all know it. And it's just, you know, social networks are... It's the young people, thank you for, you know, understanding about instant messaging, which then led us to Facebook, you know, et cetera.
Thank you for letting those people over 30 get on Facebook, guys.
Oh, my gosh. I know. It's hysterical. And, you know, my kids were like, oh, Mom, I didn't know you did that. Yep, I sure did,
yeah.
You know. And so it's just, you know, it's fascinating times we're living in. And here's, you know, Isabella Abood, who, you know, heard the call, understood, and Spirit did the rest of the connecting the dots. And the people
mm-hmm.
were waiting for her call because they knew that they wanted to do something, and here it is. So this is how, you know, this is manifestation at its in the highest order, but it's not manifesting for personal gain. This is not was never your intention,
no.
Or you would never have uprooted your family and everything else. But this is manifestation of doing God's work in a way that is the highest calling. And I know many blessings are going to come from this. I hope that you continue to be, you know, part of Spirit Seeker ongoing. I see myself coming there and with leading Awakened Retreat. You know, I know. It'll probably be 2013 because I'm just so busy, and I don't know that I'm personally going to be able to come that weekend, but I'm doing everything I can to support you. I just think
you have
a vision that is just divinely blessed. And, you know, that's how we started the Holistic Expos in 1996.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I heard, this is lovely, that, you know, people know, they just didn't know how to find the things. And here you are, you're offering harmony, you're offering the networking that happens from these events.
Yes.
You know, you can't explain it. You know, it's like, even the silence, the eye connecting with people will just, you know how it works. You know how it works. People will be drawn energetically to other people, and then the minute they can talk, there they will be, oh, by the way.
Yes.
So I just acknowledge you for creating the space for healers, peacekeepers, and light workers. And by the way, listeners, this event is free.
Yes,
you know,
is.
Isabella is trusting, you know, that, you know, people will make donations. You know, you don't have to, but of course, why would you not? You know, you're touched
yes,
by this.
Yes, we are going to be asking for love offerings, but...
Yeah.
Whatever people come
Perfect.
And they offer, whether it's their time, whether it's a quarter,
yeah.
whether it's a hug, we're willing to take it.
Yeah. So, okay, so one more time. Isabella can be reached at 573-689-1468. You can email her at izzy3241, and that's spelled izzy3241@yahoo.com. They have two Facebook pages. You know, just do a search for Isabella Abood, which is A-B-O-O-D, and you know how Facebook works. The next thing you know, you're on her two Facebook pages. And
yes.
Be sure and like it. Share the links. Don't think, oh, just Midwest, because as you can hear from this interview, the word's out every which way.
All over the country. Please.
Oh, my gosh.
So we can transcend our bodies, our minds, and our spirits to a vibration of love, peace, and harmony. That is our statement.
Beautiful. Beautiful. Okay, so this is in this issue of Spirit Seeker. I just want to mention that next week I will be interviewing Julia Cameron. She is the author of the well-known Artist Way in 1992. I found this book when I was at a one-month training to go, you know, I was processed daily. We did breathwork daily, you can imagine. And I did the Artist Way. That's when I started it, is, you know, in 1992. And it was life-changing. And she will be coming to St. Louis in October, so I will be interviewing her next week. The next week after that, I have Dr. Elaine Aaron, who is the best-selling author of The Highly Sensitive Person, and its companion book, The Highly Sensitive Person's Workbook. This is about all the empaths that are running around that don't know know what to do with these gifts, that know things about people and then feel like they're being invasive, and, you know, or else they have psychic children and they don't know what to do with them. So this is an amazing interview coming up in 2 weeks. And then after that, the final Tuesday in September, we will be hearing from Angelica Whitecliff and Michael E. Sala, the unexplainable phenomena resulting from this gentleman, Braco, from Croatia, who gazes at you, and the love that you feel is just, people are healed in his presence. Now, you can look at Braco.com, or Braco.net rather, and you'll find out more. But all of this is in the September issue of Spirit Seeker, SpiritSeeker.com. And, you know, I just want to thank all of our listeners, all the advertisers who make this magazine possible every single month for over 15 years now. I mean, this is a big deal, 15 years in print. And it's a labor of love, you know, and I couldn't do it without all of the different people who help me each month. So just like this radio show, you know, it's an honor and a privilege to do this work. So Isabella, I'm glad our paths have crossed. I just support you, and if I don't see you at this event, you know you're going to see me, you know, I will be there in spirit. And, you know, it's just challenging for me right now with I'm a single parent, total custody, and there's just like, I looked at the calendar, you know how it is.
I know.
Anyone who is a parent and on the front lines of helping, we just are, you know, we know how it is, but here we are. So,
well, thank you so much for having me on the show. I thank everybody for listening. I thank you for being a pod of Spirit Seeker. Thank you so much.
Oh my gosh, and may it continue. From my heart to yours.
Thank you all.
Okay, all right. Good night, everyone. We'll be back.
All right, love and light.
Okay, good night.
Bye-bye.
Blog Talk Radio, where millions of hosts and listeners gather.
Vinyasa, what does it mean? Let's just talk, and I'll occasionally ask a question.
I was just going to say, stop me if I'm going too quickly over something or if I miss it. Well, I'll start with the word vinyasa and our name, Valley Vinyasa, because, of course, as soon as we opened, that was immediately the most frequently asked question. It's hard to pronounce, and it's not a familiar word to people who haven't studied yoga. Vinyasa simply means to move with your breath. So in almost every form of yoga, and in most of the classes that we offer, there's this idea of linking your movement with your breath. So, for example, taking one movement on an inhale and then a subsequent movement on an exhale. And it really helps to focus you on your breathing, which, of course, is central to the practice of yoga. And it's just very good for all of your various systems to move that way. Now, vinyasa flow is also a specific style of yoga. So a lot of people have heard of that. It's a flowing type of yoga where typically you have one movement with every breath. A lot of our teachers and classes, while they're not called vinyasa perhaps, do tend to be vinyasa style classes. And the nice thing about that is, in addition to all of the mental, emotional, even spiritual benefits of yoga, you also get a very nice workout from a vinyasa flow type class. So I like to start there because, again, with our name, which is a great name, it does have some confusion sometimes for new people. As you mentioned, we have with our fall schedule, which starts next week, we're going to have over 20 classes each week.
Wow.
And they run the gamut from, we have a number of basics classes, which are, as the name implies, specifically designed for beginners who are really looking to understand the basics of a yoga class and get down some of the essential postures and movements. But it's also, basics class is also great. Even though I practice yoga almost every day, and I'm certainly capable of taking more advanced classes, I love going to basics classes because...
Well, when you read it, trust me, you're going to say, what in the world is going on here? He stands in front of a room of people and does eye gazing, and people are having miracles in his presence. And this man is not doing it for the money because he only charges $8 to be in one of his what they call sitting sessions. So that's in this issue. Kripala yoga, more than just a stretch. Redefining the peace movement, one of the best articles I have read on peace in a long time, and I think you will agree after you read that article. And then three more articles, and then, of course, there's others, but these are the ones we highlighted this month, The Highly Sensitive Person, How to Thrive When the World Overwhelms You. These are for the empaths that are walking around not knowing what to do with their skills, with the children who are the crystal children, and you're saying, What's going on? My kid knows things, is very psychic. How do I deal with this? These are highly sensitive people. And the doctor who has written a book on the subject will be my guest next week. No, 2 weeks from now. There's also the Mood Food Connection, Enjoy Your Food. This is by Denise Lynn and her daughter. I believe her name is Summer. And this book is coming out in November. Fascinating book. Fascinating book, all about changing the way you look at food, and we will be running several excerpts from this book because it is one of the best books that I've read in a long time on, you know, the mood-food connection, how eating and preparing food for your family is not something you just throw together. It's, you know, I've always felt this way. There's love and honoring of the food, and the more love that is infused in the food that you eat, the more the whole family can feel that harmony. The other article is Yoga, More Than Exercise. So here we go. I am bringing on someone that I just recently met, and I felt very drawn to her. She is a yoga teacher. She has a yoga studio, on. And we are going to be hearing about different types of yoga, what drew her, you know, and what I can say is this. I started yoga in the 1970s, got away from it, went back to it in the 80s, got away from it, and had just started it again in January when I broke my leg. And when I talked to Jennifer, the owner of Valley Vinyasa Yoga Studio, I thought, oh, this is where I'm going next. I liked her approach. I liked her article. I just liked everything. So, Jennifer, are you there?
I am here, Cynde. Thanks for having me. That's a big leap of faith, isn't it?
Oh my gosh, I know. And it's like, and I totally like was cleaning the garage over the weekend, and I think I shared with you that I had fractured this.
Yes.
Oh my gosh, this basketball came out of nowhere, and I pitched forward over it. My son is watching this, right? I look like a whirling dervish. I did two complete spins, possibly three. Like, and all I kept seeing is I kept trying to like stop with the garage floor and thinking that's concrete. Oh my gosh! But I stopped, and I'm wearing my brace. I'm a good girl, so I'm still coming to class.
Yeah. Well, we will be here whenever you're ready. And we are starting this month, actually, next week, two gentle yoga classes. So we'll have something that'll be just perfect for you and anyone coming off of an injury or who's suffering from any kind of limitation or just wants a little bit easier flow.
Yeah. Well, and you know, Jennifer, one of the people testimonials, shall we say, on your website. I'm just going to read it. I came to Valley Vinyasa 2 months after having my hip replaced. I went to strengthen and improve flexibility in my new hip and fell in love with yoga. The studio makes yoga fun and not intimidating for beginners. I love the variety of teachers and have learned something important from everyone. It has made a significant impact on my horsetick riding too. I am more centered physically and mentally. Thank you, Valley Vinyasa. So, you know, people find, and you know, we both, you know, your studio's in Chesterfield,
yes.
Missouri, and that's where I'm living. So tell me how you got started in this. I think your path started, what, in 2009?
Yes, exactly. And like many people, I started practicing yoga primarily as a form of exercise, which I think is the way that many people come to yoga. And I also just fell in love with it and really wanted to find a way to practice every day. And at that time, I was working a lot. I'm a marketing consultant by trade, and most of my clients were out in Chesterfield or even further west. So I started looking for a traditional yoga studio in the area where I could grab a class before or after work or over lunch, and just wasn't able to.
Blog Talk Radio, the world's largest online radio network.
Hello and welcome. And yes, this is Cynde Meyer, and this is the weekly radio show that is brought to you each and every week by all of the readers of Spirit Seeker Magazine, all of the people who have supported us for over 15 years. Yes, you heard that correctly. 15 years ago, Spirit Seeker was started, and it started off as a newsletter 17 years ago. And then in the September of 1997, 15 years ago, is when our first issue in print came out. We've come a long way since then. We have branched out from St. Louis, reaching across to Kansas City, and then the city, Columbia, Missouri, which is a university town in between Kansas City and St. Louis, was added about 4 years ago. And then a little over a year ago, we added Chicago. Now, the interesting thing is this, just as with Blog Talk Radio, the minute the radio interviews are done, people know that they are there in the archive. So we get weekly reports, and we have so many listeners who, for whatever reason, sometimes don't listen live, but we know that they're listening later because we get reports as to how many people are listening to the show. Same way with Spirit Seeker. We were one of the first ones to publish online. So the minute the issue is in print, the first of the month, it is online. So if you find articles that you really like, if you find an interview on Blog Talk that you really like, please, please, please send it, send the link to people, send an email saying, hey, there's this great article, or hey, there's this great radio interview. And it's helped us reach our national and international readership. And so I'm just, it's an honor and a privilege to bring this magazine to you each and every month and this radio show each and every week. We have over 200 shows archived for your listening pleasure, and a lot of people, you know, just download them to their iPod and just listen to them with their headsets. So, you know, whatever works. Now, the September issue is online, and this is National Yoga Month, so in just a few moments I'll bring my guest on. But I want to just tell you some of the articles that are in the September issue. One of them is Braco, an Unexplainable Phenomena, and this is the Croatian healer who is just, you know, read the article, I say no more, look into his eyes, and I will be interviewing two people who have worked with him for many years later this month in September. But that article...
Find anything, and was shocked by that because, as anyone who's listening is familiar with the area knows, Chesterfield is such a huge, has such a huge population, and it's a very active lifestyle, I would say, population. And she was just really surprised that there wasn't anything offered. And I don't know, it was a couple months into my search for it that I was sitting there looking at the Google results again, finding nothing. And I had just this thought, like, oh, I get it. I'm supposed to open a yoga studio in Chesterfield, which is a really odd thought because, and I know you introduced me as a yoga teacher, but I'm actually not a yoga teacher.
You know, I remember that as I said it, I was like,
yeah, no,
I
that's
said she doesn't
fine.
Teach.
No, I don't. So it's a very odd thought because most people who open yoga studios are, in fact, not only yoga teachers, but people who have been teaching yoga for quite some time. But I guess I thought that, you know, I just saw a need in the market and in that area and thought or hoped that my business skills would compensate for the fact that I don't actually teach and had not been involved in yoga for that long, actually. And 2 years later, we opened just a little over 2 years ago, I think that's more or less come to fruition. We're continuing to grow, and there's still a lot of opportunity for us to meet and reach people in the Chesterfield and West County area. But as the testimonial you read indicated, people who have found us have really enjoyed the studio and the classes and finding yoga in their lives.
Well, and you're offering 18-plus classes a week. So, mm-hmm. you know, for the, okay, since it's National Yoga Month and a lot of our listeners, you mm-hmm. know, may very well be, as you were in 2009 and myself, rediscovering yoga at this point mm-hmm. in my life, going, whoa, things have changed quite a bit. It used to mm-hmm. be there was a yoga class at the community college, and that was about it. But now people are more aware. So tell us the difference. Like, you, I know you offer, like when you were just saying, it's okay, you can come because mm-hmm. we have a gentle yoga class. Mm-hmm. So if you would be so kind, Jennifer, is to just educate the listeners, what are the different kinds of yoga that you are offering, and how is gentle? I know there's Ashtanga, I know there's, mm-hmm. okay, and what is... Mm-hmm.